Right, welcome to another session of optic communication and networks, unit 2, optical detectors and optical fiber components. Here in this session we discuss about what are the main optical fiber components. Here in previous session we discussed about the optical fiber components divided into basically passive and active, right? Here basically based upon this passive and active, now we will discuss about one by one. First one is couplers. Here, what is meant by coupler? Coupler is nothing but connecting between two channels or two devices. Whatever is coupling, not connecting between them. Connecting between two devices, two medias. Right. A coupler is a directional, which is used to combine and split signals in an optical network. That is, a coupler is used nothing but which is used to combine and split in an optical network. Here, for this best one, we are using directional coupler. Directional coupler. I think you know about directional coupler in microwave engineering. Here, what is meant by directional coupler? Directional coupler is used transmit, that is splitting and combining signals in a network. How many ports of directional coupler in general in micro engineering? Four ports. Input port, input port, receiving port, forwarding port and backward port. You know the concept of four ports in the directional coupler. Here based upon the same thing in this directional coupler. Here see this figure. How many here? Four port. Input port 1, input port 2, output port 1, output port 2. Here what is the length? Coupling length. Coupling between these two, input and output, is coupling length is L. Right. Here this is the fibers. This is the point where exactly coupling together between input and output. This is a 2 cross 2 coupler. That is 2 cross 2. 2 inputs and 2 outputs. Right. Here, where exactly these directional couplers are used? Right. Here, in this 2 cross 2 coupler, takes a fraction of alpha of the power from input 1 and place it on output 1, the remaining 1 minus alpha on the output 2. A fraction of 1 minus alpha power from input 2 is distributed to output 1, the remaining are the output. Nothing but suppose the total power is alpha. Total power is alpha. Nothing but that is whenever it transmits, whenever input transmission for the fraction of alpha power from input 1, the same will get output 1. The remaining power coming from into input 2, taking at output 2. Output, this is alpha power from input 1 to output 1, 1 minus alpha from input 2 to output 2. Here, till now we discuss only 2 cross 2, but in based upon going for applications, in real-time application, it is N cross N couplers. N cross N couplers or N cross N star coupler. Why we are using this star coupler? This is a 3 dB. It supposed 3 dB power. 3 dB power. See this one. Before taking any connections in between them, this is 1 and 2. This is also 1 and 2. Input 1, input 2. Output 1, output. This is the general 2 cross 2. Number of 2 cross 2 couplers combined together, it is a N cross N. The basic is concept is 2 cross 2 couplers. 2 inputs and 2 outputs. The combination of 2 cross 2 couplers is called as N cross N star coupler. Here in this figure shows how many numbers from 1 to 8. Here also outputs are 1 to 8. Then what is the N cross N here? 8 cross 8 star coupler. This is 8 cross 8 star coupler. Here this is the points. Is the 3 dB coupling. Is the point is the 3 dB coupling. Suppose we want connection together from 1 to 8. 1 to 8 connection. How it can be takes place? See this one. 1 to here, this point, here to here, here to here, and here to 8 connection. This is the connection between 1 to 8. Suppose 2 to 8, from 2 to here, this coupler, here to here coupler, this is how final. Likewise, from this figure, from any input to any output connect together. Any input to any output connector. This is the basic for the telecommunication network. I think some of the JNTU colleges are having a subject, telecommunication networks. But some of the some of the universities not having telecommunication network subject. Here, based upon this only, I am designing this one. Right. You see this one, how to connect from inputs to outputs for different locations of the transmitters and receivers. Here, this star coupler, why you are going to see what is the use of this star coupler? The star coupler is useful when multiple signals are needed to be combined and broadcast to many outputs. What is meant by broadcasting? Broadcasting is nothing but one to many, one transmitter, remaining are many number of receivers. That is TV broadcasting, radio broadcasting, nothing but one transmitter station, TV station here, number of receivers. In radio broadcasting, one radio broadcasting station, transmitter, remaining receivers. Here, what is the use? What is the use? Here, the couplers are also used to tap off a small portion of the power from the light stream for monitoring purpose and other reasons. See this one. Suppose in this point, we have to check how much power is transmitted through this one. We have to go for applying power. We have to fix the power meter, check the power. Check the power for different locations. Fix the power meters here and check how much power we have to calculate. Here, at the time, whenever fixing this power meter, at that time, is a tap connection. Tap connection. Why it is called a tap connection? Suppose in your home having overhead tank. From overhead tank to different locations in your home having tap connections. Right? We have to use the water for different locations in the home. Similarly, we have to use couplers. We have to check the powers. We have to connect from other devices by using couplers. Here are these couplers. Alpha value which is equal to 1. That is coupling. Coupling ratio is alpha equal to 1. But typically it is in between 0.9 to 0.95. Right. Right. Here, based upon this, we go for general equation for electric field components for the directional coupler. Let E01 and E02 electric field components. See this one. Actually, this is not E output 1, E output 2. E input 1, E input 2. Suppose I consider 2 cross 2. 2 inputs, 2 outputs. What is the electric field for input 1 is E I1 of F. What is the input for electric field for input 2 is E I2 of F. Similar for output. E not 1 F, output of 2 of F. The output of which is equal to input multiplied with E power minus I beta L. What is meant by beta? Propagation constant. What is meant by K inside here? Coupling coefficient, L is length of the coupling. That is output which is equal to, it depends upon coupling length multiplied with propagation constant and shape of the signal. Cos of KL, I sine of KL into cos KL. How these are coming? Once all of you go through the concept of scattering parameter, scattering matrix of the directional coupler, from this only I will directly write the equation here. Based upon this, see this one, E01 and E02, which is equal to S11, S12, S21, S22, input 1 and input 2. Here, what is meant S11, S12, S21 and S22 here? Scattering matrix. Scattering matrix. These are both directional coupler. Now we have to move to the next one is isolators and circulators. Right. In previous section, couplers are the most passive optical devices. not only that one, isolators and circulators also passive devices. Here, what is meant by isolator? Isolator is nothing but which transmits a signal from one point to another point. There is no reflection. That is, which transmits a signal in only one direction. How many ports of isolator? Two ports. Two ports of a isolator. Where exactly used these isolators? Isolators are used in the systems at the output of optical amplifiers and lasers. Lasers, which is used to transmit a signal in only one direction. Here, we have to discuss two key parameters for this isolator. The first one is insertion loss. The second one is isolation. What is meant insertion loss? Nothing but how much the signal is lost in a forward direction. That is, two ports at the point 1 to 2. We have to transmit from 1 to 2 port. How much signal is lost from 1 to 2? That is called the insertion loss. Next, isolation. How much signal is in the reverse direction due to reflection? Typically, the insertion loss is around 1 dB and isolation loss in 40 to 50 dB. Next one is circulator. What do you mean? The name itself shows circulator. The signal is transmitted in a circular fashion. There are two types of circulators, that is based on ports, 3-port and 4-port. Here in 3-port circulator, whenever input signal is given one, we are taking output at second port. Input at second port, output at third port. Input at third port, output at port one. Likewise, in a circular fashion only. Here in fourth port circulator, input at one, we are taking output at port two. Whenever input at port two, output at port three. Whenever input at port three, output at port four. Whenever input at port four, output at port one. Likewise, circular manner only, it works. What is the use of this circulator? Circulators are used to add or drop elements. That is, we have to adding or removing the devices. Adding or removing the devices in a network. Here, the other basic. Now, going for understanding the concept of isolation principle. The principle of this isolator working in the concept of state of polarization. State of polarization. Here, what is meant by state of polarization? How the signal works? See this one. This is a port one. This suppose we have to assume that this is the total isolated block. Port one, this one, port two here. Whenever we have to give input, incoming light polarizer. Here, see this one. Whatever input here in first position, the same. See this one. Any changes in this one? Signal changes in a vertical manner only. No changes. Once we are using Faraday rotator. Inside the isolator, Faraday rotator. Here, what is the use of Faraday rotator? The Faraday rotator, which is used to change the phase of the signal by using 45 degrees. See this one. The output of this Faraday rotator, we are getting 45 degrees change. Next, we are using polarizer. There is no change in the polar. Whatever input gives, same output. That is only 45 degrees. This is input to output. Suppose in reverse direction. We are taking same thing here. Whatever input you can polarize also the same thing. But here once we are applying this Faraday rotator, again 45 degrees change. Okay, get a vertical. Then automatically, this is the both electric and magnetic field are perpendicular to each other. This is about the concept of state of polarization. That is changing the phase. Changing the phase. Nothing but electric field can be changed. Electric field can be changed. Next one is the concept of multiplexers and filters, right? Here, what is meant by filter? Filter is used to reduce the noise. What is meant by multiplexer and demultiplexer, which is used to splitting and combining the many signals. Here, this one wavelength filter. This is one lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3, lambda. These are four types of wavelength signals we are giving to wavelength filter. But it supports only lambda, it allows, the remaining should be reflected back. What is multiplexer? Lambda 1 input signal, lambda 2, lambda 3, lambda 4 for different. All multiplex together, we are getting output is lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3 and lambda 4. This is the difference between filter and multiplexer. In filter, it allows only one wavelength, the remaining waves are reflected back. In multiplexer, all wavelengths are combined together, we are getting output. Right. Here, see this one. Different types of multiplexers and demultiplexer connect together in a network. That is, we are taking two demultiplexers, two multiplexers. Here from transmission side and receiving side. Here, see this one, lambda 1 dash, lambda 2 dash, lambda 3 dash, lambda 4 dash. Here, different types we have to connect. And finally, reach together. Here, what are the key characteristics of these filters? Here, good optical filters should have low insertion losses. And losses should be independent of the state of polarization. And passband of the filter should be insensitive. And which is used for WDM system, that is, wavelength division multiplexing system. And the filters are used to sharp the reduce the amount of energy passed through from the adjacent channels. These are some of the key characteristics of filters. That is, insertion loss should be low and independent of state of polarization and insensitive to variations from the different temperatures and used in WDM systems and reject the adjacent channel signals like this. These are some of the characteristics of the filters. Right. Do you have any query? Please type your query in a chat box. Thank you. Thank you very much for attending today's class.